Marriage occupied an important position in the culture life of the Batoro. A man would not be regarded as complete before he got married. Formally, marriage would be arranged by the parents of the boy and the girl without their knowledge, with or without their consent. During the preparations, however, the consent of the girl would have to be sought. The function was colored by the beautiful attires in celebration of the union. A long dress that is accompanied by a suka, kutia and chitambi are the traditional attire for a woman. These are meant to cover the entire body and maintain the dignity of a woman. Alice Vasemera from the Kogere Community Museum explains that the design in which one chooses to wear the traditional attire explains whether she is single, married or widowed. According to Vasemera, married women wear traditional attire with both arms well covered while the single ones, and searching ladies wear the traditional attire while exposing her arms and shoulders. For the widows, on the other hand, cover both arms but fold the suka towards their back.
When I cover myself like this, and I put on my jewelry here and my arms, even a makoito on my leg, that one shows me I'm a married lady. And I still have my husband. After that, if you find someone, puts on the suka like this. And this arm is like this out. I'm a single. And Sachi, a widow. You wear your suka like this. But this one, you have to do it like this to turn it.
Gertrude Kabaganda, a Toro culture traditional expert, says that in the Toro tradition, a married woman is not supposed to expose her body parts such as the arms, thighs, waist, among others, to the public.
Woman, you are not supposed to expose these parts of your arm because they are attractive to men. Protect their families and their affairs. Just having somebody might admire you, having seen your arm. So you're supposed to cover that one. But when you are single, you expose it for someone to see and admire. Maybe you can follow you up. Widowed, you turn this thing behind, showing that you are, it's like an expression of disappointment. Disappointment. I'm hurriedly moving away. I no longer bother.
Loneliness.
All sorts of evil and negative feelings are expressed through that kind of wearing the suka.
The men, on the other hand, wear the long council dress as their traditional wear. This is accompanied by a coat, as Henry Kato, a traditional and heritage expert, explains.
Toro man puts on a kanzu, and whenever he's going for traditional ceremonies, maybe marriage or introduction, or maybe also having a pango. That's how we're supposed to put on.
The suka is the official traditional wear for every Mutoro woman that is meant to give them a sense of belonging while preserving their culture. The suka consists of three pieces of attires, the material which is wrapped around the shoulders, usually 2.5 meters long, the dress which is usually up to knee length, and the chitambi which is wrapped around the waist and runs down to the feet. The chitambi, which is wrapped around the waist, is usually made of sateen, and for classier and beautiful look, a net matching the colors of the chitambi is sewn on top of it. The suka is mostly worn on occasions like weddings, introduction and giveaway ceremonies, and baptism, or as a church attire. Report compiled by Roger Sunday for the news.